And now, please welcome the chairman and CEO of the Television Academy, Frank Sherma.
Good evening, everyone. Television and the stories that are told have become an intricate part of our lives, entertaining, informing, and connecting us. Television is no longer just a reflection of the culture, but an invaluable part of the culture. In the midst of an unprecedented global health crisis, where the entire world has been forced to spend much more time at home than we ever thought possible, quality television shows have become a form of currency. We're all clamoring for a good new show to get lost in or to learn from. And while we can't be together in the ways we were before, we can share those shows with each other and connect over the stories. And that connection is priceless today. Television has always been the medium that helped us understand each other, be it the struggles, the joys, or the heartache. I see how that opens our eyes and hopefully brings us together as a people. In the same way we recommend shows to each other, we can use television to open portals into each other's worlds, hear each other's voices, and to see more clearly another perspective. Few have done more to widen the scope of television than Tyler Perry, this year's recipient of the Governor's Award. The Governor's Award is chosen by the Television Academy Board, a group of seasoned industry professionals who dedicate their time to fostering excellence in television. The award is only given out when there is a recipient or organization who has far exceeded the high standards of our medium. Lending their voices to honor Mr. Perry are two legends of the entertainment industry, Chris Rock and Oprah Winfrey.
In life, we're given no guarantees. In our journeys, we face roadblocks and bumpy roads, and it takes extraordinary grit and dedication to navigate the rough terrain that often life can give you and still have the internal fortitude to believe in yourself. My friend Tyler Perry has done just that against all odds. He is a man of deep faith. He is a visionary who is led by unwavering passion and a businessman who bet on himself and by doing so showed the world that there's a different path to ultimate success. Tyler is this year's recipient of the Governor's Award because he dreamed the impossible dream. He bared the unbearable sorrow and fought the unbeatable foe to run where the brave dare not go. Tyler Perry has done what no one before him has accomplished. Make it in Hollywood as an outsider.
This is not!
Knowing that the traditional Hollywood way wasn't for him, he carved his own path.
So he wrote a play, invested his own money in it, and guess what? It flopped. Hard.
I thought 1,200 people would show up, and only 30 did.
Lasted a weekend. Then he found himself living in a car, which sucks because Tyler Perry is 6'5", and his car was a Geo Metro.
Convertible.
Living like that can be a mighty motivator, and a motivated Tyler Perry would soon find success on his own terms.
And of course, Hollywood welcomed an independent black man with open arms.
Just rock with me, rock with me.
Wait, I misread that. Hollywood saw him as a fad and didn't do to help him. He did it all by himself. He's both talented and crazy, financing his own films, racking up hit after hit. In the hood, they say, I got receipts, and Tyler had receipts.
And when he did a film, we did a film, because Tyler ensured that black people would be represented in front of and behind the camera.
Tyler Perry's sets felt like watching Black Panther. There were black people everywhere. And after he amassed $1 billion at the North American box office,
hell to the yeah,
Tyler turned his eye to television.
Yes! Woo!
And just like his films, Tyler Perry did TV his way and created a whole new business model, bypassing Hollywood's traditional path and getting TBS to purchase 100 episodes of his series, House of Pain, in a deal valued at $200 million.
Yeah, damn, what?
He charted a new course on how to successfully produce television and do it fast. He shot 3 to 4 episodes in a week.
The man that always found a way to make a way. Forever innovating, Perry decided to make his own way in Atlanta, Georgia. He purchased 330 acres of land and created Tyler Perry Studios.
And the dude who was once homeless always kept those tough times in mind and reached back to those in need. Tyler's philanthropy says he is still connected to his fellow man.
Tyler Perry is a game changer who built a successful empire while ignoring every conventional norm. He is a maverick, an innovator. He's my brother, and this year's Governor's Award recipient, Tyler Perry.
I want to say a very special thank you to the Television Academy, to the Board of Governors, Kim Coleman especially, to Ari Emanuel, to Matt Johnson, to everybody at Tyler Perry Studios and my foundation. This is amazing. I didn't expect to feel this way. When I was about 19 years old, I left home and my grandmother, she gave me a quilt that she had made. And this quilt was something that I didn't really care for. It had all these different colors and these different patches in it. And I was quite embarrassed by it. I had no value in it at all. When the dog got wet, I dried him off with it. When I needed to change the oil on the car, I laid it on the ground. I had no respect for this quilt. Many years later, as I was walking past one of those fancy antique stores that I could finally go in and shop, I saw in the window a quilt that looked just like the one that she had given me. And as I'm in the store wondering where that quilt was, there was an attendant who walked up to me and said, "Let me tell you about this quilt. It was made by an African-American woman who was a former slave, and each patch in the quilt she had put in represented a part of her life. One part was from a dress that she was wearing when she found out that she was free. Another part was from her wedding dress when she jumped the broom." And as I was hearing this story, I became so embarrassed. Here I was, a person who prides myself on celebrating our heritage, our culture, and I didn't even recognize the value in my grandmother's quilt. I dismissed her work and her story because it didn't look like what I thought it should. Now, whether we know it or not, we are all sewing our own quilts with our thoughts, our behaviors, our experiences, and our memories. Like in my own quilt, one of my memories when I was about 10 years old, I remember my father standing at the door, and I was wondering why he stood there so long. He was frustrated, and he walked away, and I asked my mother what was going on. She said he had worked all week, and he was waiting for the man to come and pay him, and he never did. They needed the money at the time. And I tell you, she was so frustrated, she turned to me, and she said, "Don't you ever stand by a door waiting for white folks to do nothing for you." Now, you got to understand, my mother wasn't a racist. But in her quilt, she couldn't imagine a world where her son was not waiting by the door for someone. In her quilt, she couldn't imagine me actually building my own door and holding that door open for thousands of people. In my mother's quilt, she couldn't imagine me owning land that was once a Confederate Army base, where Confederate soldiers plotted and planned on how to keep blacks enslaved. And now, on that very land, black people, white people, gay, straight, lesbian, transgender, ex-cons, Latin, Asian, all of us come together working, all coming together to add patches to a quilt that is as diverse as it can be, diversity at its best. I stand here tonight to say thank you to all of the people who are celebrating and know the value of every patch and every story and every color that makes up this quilt that is our business, this quilt that is our lives, this quilt that is America. Because in my grandmother's quilt, there were no patches that represented black people on television. But in my quilt, her grandson is being celebrated by the Television Academy. I thank you for this. God bless you. Thank you.